most believes about, yeah, about this kid who was demon possessed. Today, before I say more, I remind you, we start yesterday started the big exhibition, the first exhibition in Asia about icons. Here we have the master, George Cordis, and in the World Religious Museum. So please go there to visit and see the Orthodox painting, the Orthodox art. It is an event in all the TVs and all the news in Taiwan. It was, and please, it will be a good experience to you to go and see there the icons and the deep spiritual environment, and to send your friends also to visit. Now, today we see many things about the kids. A kid was suffering, he was demon possessed. Other people say it was not demon possession, but it was an epilepsy. But even if it was an epilepsy, it was also something with demons, because Jesus cast out the demons, so it could be both, okay? Or could be the one to seem like epilepsy, because there are different, you know, different manifestations of this. But anyhow, many times, because we are adults and we care about ourselves, we don't think and we don't care about the diseases and the, let's say, the spiritual and the psychological life of the kids. And this, unfortunately, it is not good, because, you know, the kids cannot express themselves. A good doctor, for example, who is a child doctor, you know, it's very difficult to be a child doctor. Why? Because the kid cannot say, I have a pain here, or I have a pain here, like the doctor normally is asking us, right? So he can guess, and he must be very smart and very well trained to understand from just one side or some reactions. Now, we see the kids that they cannot speak and they cannot communicate with us with a logical way, that they have many problems that we overlook. And why we overlook? Because of our proudness. Because we can consider the kids our toys. There are people who think, I love my kids, and I have dream for them to continue my life. These people, not only they don't love anybody, they are just very proud parents. They don't even deserve the name of a parent. They love themselves and they want dogs. There are people who say, I cannot live without kids. Why? Why you cannot live without kids? You want dogs. You want to play with human souls. And because we speak here about the problems of the kids, there are so many. The worst problem is what? The lack of love between the father and the mother. When the parents, they say, oh, now we don't have love between us, but we have the kids to take care. Already their marriage has a big problem. Because the kid is, the main thing of the kid is not the expensive food that you give, but through the mutual love of the husband and the wife. If the husband and the wife quarrel, if they hate each other, if they put their pridefulness to each other, the kid is recorded like the best recorder, not like we have the camera here, because the mind records and it stays forever in the subconscious mind. And when the conditions will not be well in his life, this they will come up, and he will not know even why this is happening. And sometimes, maybe some psychologists, through hypnosis, through other techniques, he will see the trauma, he will see the wound that the parents cause to the kid. It is very terrible. Most that the parents, they quarrel, I don't say in front of the kid, in front or behind, the kid knows. It is very bad that people think that the highest science, which is how to show love, how to be a parent or a mother or a father. They did not study, and they don't want to study, to buy a book. They think that I know. Who are you that you know? You come from a spoiled family. You carry the disease of your parents, and of your mother and your father, and you transmit this to your kid. And then you say, why my kid is sick? Why my kid has psychological problems? Because of you. Because you need dolls to play and project your selfishness. Because you cannot project your husband, probably he will beat you, or probably he will do something else. So you project your disease to the kids, which cannot react, cannot do anything. Unfortunately, it's like that, and don't be surprised at what I say. I say the truth. And if a priest dares to say the truth to the people, to a person like this, of course he will not come again to the church. He will, or she will, consider the priest the worst enemy. It happens here, or actually. And, you know, this will keep terrible. Continue to destroy the kid. It is especially for the Orthodox family. If you don't receive the Holy Communion, you cannot give to your kids other good things. Because we never receive the Holy Communion for ourselves. We receive through myself to go the Holy Communion, to go to my beloved people, to go to my husband, to my wife, even if the husband is not Orthodox, is not even Christian, it's okay. The grace of God goes to him through the blessed marriage, or to her, and to the kids, of course. It is very bad, so that the parents don't care to receive the Holy Communion, because they don't believe, they don't care. They say, I'm Orthodox. Like, I support this football team. They don't really believe. For them, it's just a political, or an economical, or a football faith, just to belong somewhere. And if the priest dares to say something to this person, of course, the priest is bad. And they would say to the other, see, so bad is this priest. Because he reveals myself. Well, of course, they will not say this. For the Orthodox kids, of course, we give them the highest thing on heavens and on earth, which is the Holy Communion. Even, even if they don't intellectually understand, because the kids understand more than us, because they are very pure, and sometimes they can see what we don't see, the body of Jesus Christ, the Jesus Christ himself, only they don't know how to express it. It happened to me many times to see a kid to say, oh, this, I don't see it, the kids see it. But you see, the parents don't care many times to bring the kids to receive the Holy Communion, which, as I say again, there is no higher thing on heavens and on earth than the body of Jesus Christ. We buy the most expensive vitamins, medicine, you know, to give to the kids. And it's good what we do, but this is free. And because it's free, the people don't appreciate. And you see the kids, they come to the church, their parents don't teach them. They think that the church is a painting house. It's not. It is a place of the Lord Jesus Christ. And why they don't teach? Because in their house they don't pray. They say, I'm Orthodox because I have a big cross. And where is the cycle and what is this? Is God there or there? Just this. This has nothing to do with the faith. Because they don't pray in their house. They teach the kids that the church is a place of drawing. It's a small school for drawing. I have seen kids here, we'll never forget here, Artyom, very small kid, he was sitting like this, always, holding the candle. And when the candle, you know, have this box fall on his head, he was crying, but he did not leave. Why these kids were like this? And the others, they come here shouting and drawing and turning their back to the holy table. Because the parents don't give, they don't care. And they hate the priest because he says the truth. He's the bad person, but it's okay. This is my reward, I know. But it's for Jesus Christ that you care. You don't come to my house. And so there are kids. I will never forget Arthur and his brother. And you know, so first we give the Holy Communion the best thing, and of course we give the other things. I remember my spiritual father, Saint Porphyrius, I will never forget this. When the family came, husband and wife, and they had two kids, 15 and 17 years old, I was in the room, he said, stay. So I stayed, and the parents say, well, see, our kids, they don't obey us, they started going out, and you know, like the kids in the teens, they start to do different things, and he say, I feel a little bit sorry to say, you are responsible for your kids. And the other say, how? Because we are good Christians. He say, yes, you are good Christians, as you say, but when you were pregnant, did you put your hands here to pray for your kid, the husband and the wife? They say, oh, we never know this. He say, yeah, but if you pray for your kid, the kid knows, and the grace of God goes to the kid, because you have power as father and mother. And when the kid grow up, if you take it to the church to receive the Holy Communion, you say, well, sometimes we wanted, it was cold. It was not in the morning, too early morning, the kids cannot wake up. Of course, if it is for the hospital, they will go, they will, right? And they made the kids the kings of their family, and they destroy them because they make them puppets for their proudness. The toy that they were missing, and not to think that this is a soul, that it has her own rights and must grow in the grace of God for him, not for them, and for all the human beings, and last for them. The proud people. And then he said to them, do you quarrel? He said, of course we quarrel. Say, well, this is what you do to your kids. Because when you quarrel, you put a knife to the soul of the kid. You must remember this thing. Because you know, we forget that Jesus Christ said what? If you don't turn and become as a kid, you will never see the kingdom of heavens, right? You remember this. And we overlook the theology of the king, of the childhood. We overlook this, and we project to the childhood our own personality, and our own proudness, and our own diseases because of this. And here we see the kid that was sick, and the mother does not appear, and it is strange. She's not dead, she does not seem to be dead. Probably the mother did not care. Probably it was a quarreling family, right? Why the mother did not come? Only the father was shouting, and his faith was not enough, because God did seems, because he wanted to cure the total situation. Because if he cures the kid will not be really cured, because it was the father sick, and the mother seems to be more sick because she does not come. And from this point of view, you see, you know, the cure is not a mechanical thing, it's not like a robot, it's not like to press a button. So the father, who had not enough faith, he went to the disciples, they tried to do something, this did not work. Why? We don't know exactly, we cannot say, I cannot say. Probably, as Jesus Christ says, not enough faith. Probably, for other reasons, as I guess, to cure the father. To cure the mother who did not come, right? And then, you know, the father falls on his knees and says something that we all should say, Lord, give me faith. And we must understand that the faith is a gift of God. And the fact that I'm a priest here, it is not that I'm a professional performer. I don't perform the liturgy. As long as God is giving me faith, I do. I serve the liturgy. Pray to have his faith, not take his grace from me and from you. Because, as I say, the faith is not some intellectual thing. Finally, it's a gift, a very great gift of God to everybody of us. And he can take it back. So the father was crying and saying, give me faith. And when he did this, then Jesus Christ ordered. So the father is going to cure. He abandons his own sick understanding of religion. I'm a good Jewish, I believe to God, I go to the temple, I give my money to the temple, right? I'm a good person. But now he understands he has not enough faith. And faith is this trust and the love of God. So, you know, he's asking. And God is doing it. The miracle. The evil spirit comes out. And Jesus takes the key, And it's very important to allow Jesus to take the keys, because he loves them more than us. Remember this, Jesus loves your kids more than you. He is keeping them and me and you alive this time. I can have a heart attack now and die, right? There are millions of thrombs coming in my lungs, in my brain, right? And me and you, you know, we are alive. It's a very complex system. You cannot predict, no? And it is the miracle and the grace of God that keeps us alive. So Jesus loves your kids more than you. And, you know, so the miracle happens. But the father, happy and cured also, he returns to the house, probably to see the sick, unbeliever mother, and gradually see to be cured. And the disciples now, they say, well, why we did not succeed? Because, you know, they did not really understand that the miracle is not just the power to say, okay, now I want this, and this appeared. It works in order to the love of God and the help of the community, and to help all the community together, not to show off. The disciples are not mature for this yet. Even their faith was not enough. How do we know? Of course, when Jesus was arrested, he just left him, right? So they did not even say one good word for him. One good word for him. And this is why Jesus says about his passion. Because they say, well, you know, why we did not do it? Because 1 week later, 2 weeks later, they will abandon him. So I will finish saying to you, saying to God, give me faith. And what is the faith? The love. Give me love. And say to your kids to pray for you, not you to pray for them. And remember that your kids belong to God first. And respect them. And don't think that the church is a playground here. But they come here to pray. As long as they don't pray, this reflects what you teach them. May the Holy Spirit protect all of us. Amen. We have good food here.